Sinong may kagagawa nito? Hindi makakaalis si Alice Guo kung walang tumulong sa kanya ng mga opisales ng pamahalaan para tayong ginisa sa sarili nating mantika. Pero paano kung ang law enforcement mismo ang kailangan imbestigahan? What if they drop the ball? Paano kung sila ang dapat managot? Nangako ang BI sa akin at sa Senate President pro tempore na hindi nila hahayaan si Guo Huaping na makaalis sa Pilipinas. Eh yun pala, ay wala na talaga siya. Mr. President, kung hindi po natin ito gawan ng paraan as an institution, as a country, parang nagpasampal tayo sa dayuhang ito na paulit-ulit ni sinaula ang ating mga batas, patakaran. Magtangkapay ang si Guo Huaping bumalik dito sa Pilipinas. Siguro naman, huhulihin na talaga siya, di po ba? Pero sa ginawa niya pong iyon na niloko tayo sa loob ng isang buwan, yung pala ay nasa labas na, ewan ko na lang po kung babalik pa yan dito o lalong papalit. And tungkol po dun sa CCTV, mukhang sanay itong si Guo Huaping. Maybe this is not the first time she did this. Dahil kung i-enlarge po natin yung photo dun sa ipinakita kong slide kanina, hindi po na-capture ang image niya dun sa CCTV. So dumaan or idinaan siya sa spots na hindi mahuhuli kahit yung video image niya. So baka may nagturo, tama po si Sen Grace, baka may nagturo sa kanya at hindi lang dito sa immigration natin, posibleng sa immigration ng iba pang ASEAN countries. Salamat, Mr. President.
You cannot leave. The CAP can fine or actually dismiss pilots in the failure to name the members in the manifest. And it has to be the authentic name. It has to be a certified name with passport. So my suggestion, Mr. President, to the committee is to go back and subpoena, of course, CAAP, and if they give you the documents on who the chartered plane that provided this escape, then you can subpoena these individuals. Pero imposibleng darating yan sa international port na walang document kung anong eroplanong sinakyan niya at yung airplane number, because that's a violation of international law.
Lubos ang pagkadismaya ni Senator Risa Hontiveros nang mapag-alaman niya na isang buwan na palang nakaalis ng bansa papuntang Malaysia ang na-dismiss na mayor ng Bambantarlak na si Mayor Guo. Sa mga dokumentong napasa kay Senator Hontiveros, gabi ng ika-17 ng July nakalabas ng Pilipinas si Guo at lumipad patungo ng Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, gamit ang kanyang Philippine passport. Nang gagalaiti ngayon sa galit si Senator Hontiveros dahil nakatakas si Guo, aniya, hindi makakaalis ng Pilipinas si Guo kung walang tumulong sa kanya na mga opisyal ng gobyerno. Dagdag pa niya, para tayong ginisa sa sarili nating mantika.
Majority Leader, Mr. President, dear colleagues, I rise on a question of privilege.
The lady may proceed.
Salamat tabi, Mr. President. I rise to speak against an assault on the rights, privileges, reputation, conduct, decorum and dignity of the Senate, as well as the integrity of its proceedings. Last month po, o noong July 13, 2024, naglabas ang Senado through the Senate Committee on Women, Children, Family Relations and Gender Equality and approved by the Senate President
ng contempt citation and order to arrest laban sa Chinese national na si Guo Huaping, also known as Alice Leal Guo. Nagpapasalamat ako sa Senate President sa maagap na tugon nila para mailabas ang arrest order. At salamat din kina General Angkan na alam ko binuhos ang buong puwersa at lakas para sa operasyon na hanapin si Guo Huaping ng Senate OSAA. But Mr. President, I am now in receipt of information that this person was already in fact out of the country on July 18, 2024 to Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Ipapakita ko po ang dokumentong ito bilang patunay na pumasok sa Malaysia si Alice Guo. Siya po ay pumasok ng 12:17, 13 seconds military time ng July 18. Kaya ibig sabihin, umalis siya ng Pilipinas sa gabi ng July 17. Mr. President, hindi po pwedeng ipagkaila na siya ito dahil match na match po ito sa kanyang Philippine passport na ipa-flash ko ngayon. Maraming salamat sa NBI sa impormasyong ito. Patuloy ang pag-track nila kay Alice Guo. Ayon sa aking isa pang source, Mr. President, tumuloy si Alice Guo sa Singapore kung saan nagtagpo-tagpo sila ng kanyang magulang na sina Lin Wenyi at Guo Jianzhong. The couple flew in from China on July 28, 2024. Mistulang reunion sila doon kasama sina Wesley Guo at Cassandra Ong. Mr. President, who allowed this travesty to happen? Sinong may kagagawa nito? Hindi makakaalis si Alice Guo kung walang tumulong sa kanya ng mga opisales ng pamahalaan para tayong ginisa sa sarili nating mantika. I have always believed that legislative hearings are policy-driven. Kaya nung nag-announce na ng ban ang Pangulo, sabi ko, we have done our jobs. Let law enforcement take the lead. Pero paano kung ang law enforcement mismo ang kailangan imbestigahan? What if they drop the ball? Paano kung sila ang dapat managot? Nangako ang BI sa akin at sa Senate President pro tempore na hindi nila hahayaan si Guo Huaping na makaalis sa Pilipinas. Eh yun pala, ay wala na talaga siya. Mr. President, kung hindi po natin ito gawan ng paraan as an institution, as a country, parang nagpasampal tayo sa dayuhang ito na paulit-ulit ni sinaula ang ating mga batas, patakaran at proseso. Salamat po, Mr. President.
Mr. President.
Senator Tulfo is recognized.
I'd like to make a manifestation in support of...
You may proceed, sir.
Senator Rizondevero said, tama yung sinabi niya, dapat gawa natin paraan. A few weeks ago, I did have a hearing sa Committee on Public Services at napuna ko po yung walang processing center. Ang lahat ng mga kababayan natin lumalis papuntang abroad. Walang processing center. Pag ikaw ay isang pasahero, gustong pumunta ng abroad sakay ng isang chartered plane, hindi ka nadadaan sa proseso, hindi ka nadadaan sa immigration, diretso-diretso ka na sa gate, sakay ng limousine mo, SUV, and then pagdating sa tarmac, aakit ka ng aeroplano mo, and then here comes the CIQ, Customs, Immigration, and Quarantine. At kung yun ay kasabwat, Alice Guo, madaling makakalusot dahil walang CCTV na dadaanan. That's why I told people sa NIA, by the end of this year, kapag wala pa rin processing center ang mga chartered plane, ako po yung magagalite, I will really raise hell. This is one example kung bakit ito si Alice Guo ay nakalabas. I'm very sure, walang nakalagay kung anong aeroplano, right, going out. I'm very sure ito ay lumabas through a chartered plane, through a private plane. So all we need to do is tanungin natin kung matitresyan kung sino, ano mga private plane ang lumabas o chartered plane ang lumabas that very day from the Philippines. Doon natin matatrack down. At sino yung CIQ, Customs Immigration, Quarantine, ang nag-process ng kanilang passport sa loob ng aeroplano. Because ang nangyari ngayon, Mr. President, kahit na sinong Ponce Pilato sakay ng kanyang limousine, nag-charter siya ng plane, nag-direction niya sa tarmac, and then akit siya sa loob ng aeroplano, bit-bit-bit-bit ang kanyang mga maleta. Ito pa, yung pagkuha ng mga information pag dumantay sa immigration, yun po ay useless. Yung biometrics, kinukunan tayo ng picture, etc. Useless po yun dahil wala tayong tinatawag na cross-matching. We don't have that capability yet. So ibig sabihin, itong si Alice Guo, pwedeng bumalik to ng Pilipinas, mga kapusit na hindi natin alam, sapagkat all she needs to do is same mukha niya, basta palitan lang niya yung kanyang pangalan, makakalusot na siya. So this has to be changed. At again, ako'y nanawagan sa mga taga-NAIA, MIA, immigration, get your act together dahil by the end of this year, gusto ko magkaroon ng processing center ang lahat ng pasahero going in and coming out of the country. Kailangan may processing center na sila itadaan sa butas ng karayom tulad ng dinadaanan ng lahat ng mga simpleng pasahero. Maraming salamat, Mr. President.
Mr. President.
Salamat po, Mr. President. Ako po, kung magtangka pa yung si Guo Huaping bumalik dito sa Pilipinas, siguro naman huhulihin na talaga siya, di po ba? Pero sa ginawa niya pong iyon na niloko tayo sa loob ng isang buwan, yung pala ay nasa labas na, ewan ko na lang po kung babalik pa yan dito o lalong papalayo sa atin. Salamat po, Mr. President.
Mr. President.
Senator Poe, what is your pleasure?
Actually, I would also like to confirm that during some instances in the past, there are private planes that have taken off and there was a conflict between the immigration and the airport security group. At least in the main thoroughfares, in the main airports, meron talagang airport security group at may immigration. Pero sa mga ibang lugar, kung sa north man yan, dun sa mga PESA zones, kung may mga airport doon, I think we should also have an inventory. What day did she arrive in Malaysia? For example, if CAAP has a record of all departures from the Philippines and from where, because I'm sure we have a list, if they went to Malaysia, ilan yung mga flight papuntang Malaysia, whether it's private or a passenger plane, we should be able to determine that. Kasi, syempre, meron yung traffic, di ba? So, they should have a master list of who had taken off and have reached for an international flight. So, that's one possibility for us to be able to track them. Pero, ang ginawa natin dati sa NAIA, also for the information of the new chair of the Committee on Public Services, lahat ng mga gates, may mga CCTV na para yung sa mga, kasi nangyayari dito sa mga private planes, papasok sila dun sa mga side entrance ng airport, hindi alam kung sino mga pasahero dun, kunyari Grandia na tinted. Dapat yan ngayon, may mga pwede natin imbisigahan kung kinukunan lahat ng mga nakasakay sa loob, kasi minsan napupuslit pumapasok sa eroplano, hindi nakikita ng immigration or ng airport security group. So that's all, Mr. President. Thank you.
Mr. President, if I may, Mr. President, salamat kay Sen. Grace. And tungkol po dun sa CCTV, mukhang sanay itong si Guo Huaping. Maybe this is not the first time she did this. Dahil kung i-enlarge po natin yung photo dun sa ipinakita kong slide kanina, hindi po na-capture ang image niya dun sa CCTV. So dumaan or idinaan siya sa spots na hindi mahuhuli kahit yung video image niya. So baka may nagturo, tama po si Sen. Grace, baka may nagturo sa kanya at hindi lang dito sa immigration natin, posibleng sa immigration ng iba pang ASEAN countries. Salamat, Mr. President.
Mr. President, Senator Lauren Legarde is taking the floor.
Senator Legarde is recognized for her manifestation. You may proceed, ma'am.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President. May I request that the good sponsor answer some questions for my enlightenment? I wanted to associate myself with a speech of the Deputy Minority Leader. She and Senator Sherwin Gatsalian and many of our colleagues have been very aggressive and persistent in trying to thresh out this problem of illegal and foreign nationals who have been elected into office. And this really is a national security concern. Aside from the fact that this Mayor Guo had left the country and supposedly having been assisted by law enforcers or even officials of government, because there was already a hold or a ban, but she was able to leave. And whether there's a video or not, those are details. But we must further investigate, and the Deputy Minority Leader is correct, and how these agencies of government must be answerable on how a wanted person is able to escape the country. I also would like to bring to the attention that more than 1,200 have been given, according to the PSA, and this has been reported already, have been given birth certificates. Who knows if one of those 1,200 would also run for elective office. A councilor, a barangay captain, a mayor, we don't know. So, dapat isama po sa ating pagpupulong at sa mga hearing yung higit sa 1,200 na inamin na ng PSA na nabigyan niya ng birth certificate. So, having said that, at the proper time, if and when this will be brought to the floor once again, there were just questions I would like to do in support of the manifestation of Senator Ontiveros. Thank you.
Mr. President.
Senator Gatchalian is recognized. Yeah.
Mr. President, talaga pong pinaglalaruan ho tayo at iniinsulto ang ating institusyon dahil noong August 15, 2024, nag-file po si Guo Huaping aka Alice Guo ng motion to reopen and admit attached counter affidavit. Ito po yung patungkol sa kaso niya na i-file po ng DOJ sa human trafficking. At dito po sa counter affidavit, meron pong notary public na notarized po on August 14, 2024 by a certain attorney Elmer Galica na yung kanyang opisina ay nasa San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. At pinapunta ko ho yung staff ko to verify whether this law firm is indeed legit. May law firm naman po, may tao naman po sa law firm. Wala ho si attorney Galica doon, pero nakausap po ng staff ho natin sa telepono. At ang sabi ho ni attorney Galica na si Guo Huaping ay pumunta sa kanya personally on August 14, 2024. So, talaga hong may pinagluloko ho tayo dahil parang lumalabas at bumabalik. At despite na meron pong arrest warrant, ay hindi ho ito pinapansin at imbes lumalabas at bumabalik po sa ating bansa. Kung totoo po na meron ho siyang personal appearance dito po kay Attorney Galica. So, dapat ho maimbitahan rin po ito si Attorney Galica sa next hearing po ni Senator Rizzo Ontiveros para marinig ho sa kanya mismo kung talaga bang merong personal appearance. Dahil ho, sabi niya, base po sa interview ng ating staff, na meron pong personal appearance po sa kanya. Mr. President, let me correct myself. It's Attorney Elmer Galicia. Attorney Elmer Galicia, na ang office po ay sa San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. No? So, kaya ho, Mr. President, talaga pong pinaglalaruan po yung ating institusyon at itong taong to, itong abogadong to ay dapat po maimbitahan para malaman ho natin ang katotohanan. Either siya ho'y nagsisinungaling at wala pong personal appearance o talagang balik-labas po ng ating bansa na lumalampas po sa Bureau of Immigration dahil hindi naman po makakalabas at makakabalik po ng ating bansa kung hindi po tinatatakan po yung kanyang pasaporte. So maraming salamat sa Senator Risa for bringing this out and maraming salamat po at napag-usapan ho natin.
Noted.
Maraming salamat po, Sen. Sherwin, and very well taken po, Mr. President, na sa patuloy naming pagdinig dito sa usapin ng POGO sa Senate Committee on Women ay tatawagin yung resource person na sinabi ni Sen. Sherwin na si Attorney Galicia. Salamat po.
Yes.
Salamat
po. Mr. President, Majority Leader, really quick. Really
Senator
quick.
Zabiri is recognized.
Thank you. I don't want to delay the proceedings, particularly in the third reading vote, but I'd like to congratulate Senator Risa for bringing this up. We support her on this particular issue. And as early as last year, if you can recall, when I was presiding in one of the budget deliberations, I made mention the fact, hindi pa pumuputok ito si Mayor Guo, hindi pa pumuputok itong issue na to, that there was a town in Mindanao that was issuing fake birth certificates, late registration. I mentioned it there. It was picked up by the media. This is November of 2023. And tama pala yung pinalabas ko na information and now it seems that the PSA has validated almost over 1,600 or 1,700 fake late registration birth certificates. So at that time, I remember that the NBI, when I spoke to them, said that they had no evidence of such thing happening. So I want to thank Senator Risa Ontiveros Committee for, and together with Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, for bringing this out, that this was actually happening. If we did not bring that out as early as then and now, I would just dread to believe what would happen to our country. It would be a nation of fake Filipinos. And on the issue of the plane, Your Honor, Mr. President, just a tip to my distinguished colleague. If you have the document, the arrival document in Malaysia, they will always have the flight number. Meron yun, sure yun. Impossible na registered yung flight number na yan. If the flight number now registers to a chartered plane, then you can find out who owns the chartered plane. And dahil nga masyadong popular ito si Mayor Go, kilala siya. Sigurado kilala ng piloto kung sinong pasahero nila. Imposibleng hindi makikilala. Matatanong mo sila bakit nila hindi na i-report na ito po ang pasahero nila. Because you have also manifest. You cannot leave. The CAAP can fine or actually dismiss pilots in the failure to name the members in the manifest. And it has to be the authentic name. It has to be a certified name with passport. So, my suggestion, Mr. President, to the committee is to go back and subpoena, of course, CAAP, and if they give you the documents on who the chartered plane that provided this escape, then you can subpoena these individuals. Pero, imposibleng darating yan sa international port na walang document kung anong eroplanong sinakyan niya at yung airplane number, because that's a violation of international law. So thank you, Mr. President. Thank you to our distinguished colleague.
Thank you, Senator. It's a very...
Salamat po, Mr. President, at kay Sen. Migs. Maigi nga po na in the course of the investigation, nag-step up po talaga yung iba't ibang executive agencies and constitutional bodies. Siguro may parallel pressure or support sa isa't isa, no? Tayo dito sa legislature at yung ilang opisina sa executive at constitutional bodies para talaga to be equal to this task, lalo na napaka mapanghamon yung mga issue na hinaharap sa atin ng POGO at mga katulad ni Guo Huaping. And again, very well taken po yung mga payo na ibinigay, mga dagdag na resource persons para sa isa sa mga huling pagdinig ng komite namin laban sa POGO. At aming salamat, Mr. President.
Mr. President, if I may.
Senator Jingoy.
Yeah, first of all, I would like to associate myself with the manifestation of Senator Risa. If my memory serves me right, during the hearing of the committee chaired by Senator Risa, I asked the representative of the BID bluntly if Mayor Alice Go is still here in the country as we speak. And then he said, yes, he is still here. So we have to hold the BID responsible also for this fiasco. And one more thing, Mr. President, I don't think that Mayor Alice Go chartered a plane in Naiya. Dahil una-una, kilalang tao to. Mapera, masyado na-expose sa TV, so kilalang-kilala. So I don't think nag-charter itong si Mayor Alice Go sa Naiya. Siguro nag-charter ng plane yan sa ibang maliliit na airport kung saan tahimik ang mga tao ron. Like for example, sa... may maliit na Katarman, halimbawa. O sa Katiklan, yung mga hindi masyadong busy airport, nag-charter na plano. Gagamit lang ng fake passport yan, pwede ka nang umalis. Sino magmamonitor doon sa mga maliliit na airport? Meron ba tayong mga ka-app doon? Meron ba tayong mga BID doon? Wala. So it's easy to escape here in the Philippines pagka meron ka talagang kaso. Kung pumunta ka lang sa mga maliliit na airport, mag-charter ka ng plane, maraming pera eh. Oh, punta ka Hong Kong. Dalawang oras nandun ka na. Wala na tayong hapon. Wala po, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Jingoy.
Mr. President, one last point, if I may, to one of the points raised by the Senate President pro tempore. In fact, it appears in that initial information given by NBI and by another ASEAN immigration authority, it appears na si Guo Huaping used her Philippine passport in this flight last month. Salamat po, Mr. President.
Mr. President, very short manifestations.
Yes, Senator Villanueva.
Thank you very much. First of all, let me congratulate and again commend our dear colleagues' observation on this particular issue, Senator Risa Ontiveros, because we have
been experiencing this for quite a long time, and it's about time that we take the cudgels of really asking for the highest form of accountability to these government offices, Mr. President. Let me just remind the body in 2016 about the biggest human trafficking syndicate that we unearthed in this August chamber, in this institution, wherein more than 1,300 illegal workers in Clark ay na-unearthed natin. And involved po dito, Mr. President, yung dalawang deputy commissioner ng Bureau of Immigration na nakita rin natin sa TV, sa CCTV, na humingi ng 50 milyong piso. So, talagang hindi bago, Mr. President, itong mga salarin at itong mga rascals ng industriya ng Pogo para i-bribe itong ating mga nangangasiwa ng border control natin. Pinapakita din ito, Mr. President, yung kalakihan ng challenge that we have on our hand about the inefficiencies of our system. So, I join my colleagues in asking for these personalities, not only the lawyer that was mentioned by Senator Gatchelian, the NAIA personnel, the BI personnel, airport security groups, etc. na meron pong live warrant of arrest ito at nakakahiya na sa mga otoridad na may warrant of arrest ito for so long, hindi pa rin nila makita, hindi pa rin nila matuntun kung nasan itong individual na ito. Maraming salamat.